Good evening to one and all present here. First of all, on behalf of all the cast and the Middle School Drama Club, I, Leonie, welcome you all. Today, we are going to present before you our middle school drama, Spreading the News, written by Lady Gregory by 1907. The plot of this one-act play, first performed at the Abbey Theatre's opening night, was easily summarized. Bartley Fallon, a peasant visiting the fair at his country town, announces the gloomy philosophy early in the action. If there's ever any misfortune coming to this world, it's on myself it pitches. Almost immediately, the prophecy becomes self-fulfilling, and the carnival of misunderstandings among the Tarpey people lead to a steadfast conviction that Bartley has killed a man. By the time his alleged victim, Jack Smith, reappears on stage towards the end of the play, the rumors have achieved such intense life that the suspicious magistrate marches both men off as co-conspirators in the foul murder everyone has been talking about. This play portrays life that happened in his surrounding, in the neighborhood which gossip always spread fast. Before we start our skit, I would like to introduce you to our characters. Bartley Fallon, a habitual pessimist, a complaining fox, convinced that bad things will always happen to him.
If there's ever any misfortune coming to this world, it is on myself that it's sure to come.
Mrs. Fallon, a bit belligerent but supportive of her husband, until there is a suggestion that he has been unfaithful.
My nice, quiet man, my decent comrade, there is no better man and no nicer man in this whole five parishes.
No. Jack Smith, the supposed victim, owns a hay fort.
It isn't to the fair I came myself, but to the 5-acre meadows.
The magistrate, an overzealous bumbling idiot, given to what supposition and also staying in the office. Two policemen and the magistrate act as if they are the great and the right one. The magistrate is always proud with his system and the arm of our island.
When I was in the Andaman Islands, my system never failed. Yes, my system never failed.
Mrs. Tarpey, lady having difficulty in hearing.
What? What did you say? Look, no, who's a great heart if the damage puts upon me?
Sean Early.
What? Do you tell me so?
Kim Casey.
Following Jack Smith with a hay fork? Did anyone hear the like of that?
James Ryan. Charlie.
Yes, yes, with a hay fork.
Mrs. Tudie.
Why would he injure him? There was many men killed with no more of a weapon than a hay fork.
Brady.
What is going on over here? I didn't want to know. Let me just watch.
Brody. Sean Early, Kim Casey, James Ryan, Charlie, Mrs. Tilly, Brittany, and Ronnie were irresponsible people. They spread the news without facts. They were much talked people, making them such a great one. They seemed to be a busybody.
system. What a repulsive sight.
That is so indeed, sir.
I believe there is a good sense of disorder in this place.
There is.
Common assault?
It's common enough.
Varian crime, no doubt.
That is so.
Boycotting, mending of cattle, firing into houses.
There was one time, sir, and there might be again.
Bad is bad. Doesn't go any further than bad.
Far enough, indeed.
Homicide, then. This district has been shamefully neglected. I will change all that. When I was in the Andaman Islands, my system never failed. Yes, my system never failed. What has that woman on her stall?
Apples, most sweet and sweets.
Just see if there are any unlicensed goods underneath. Spirit or not, we had invasions of the salt tax in the Andaman Islands.
I see no spirits here, sir, or salt.
Do you know the song well, my good woman?
An apple? A bed is a whole golden, your honor.
This gentleman is asking if you know the town. He's the new magistrate.
Well, do you?
Well, I know the town.
Well, I do to be sure.
What is it, big business?
Business, is it? Well, what business would the people here have but to be anyone another's business?
No, I mean, what trade do they have? What trade do they have?
Not a trade, no trade at all but to be talking.
I shall learn nothing here. The smoke from that man's pipe has reached Luke. He may be going unlicensed tobacco at his home. I wish I had brought my telescope to this district. Come with me to the post office. I will telegraph for it. I found it very useful in the Andaman Islands.
Bad luck to throw Malden. Knocking my apples this way and that way, showing off he was to the new magistrate.
So you might indeed.
And it's a great expense for a poor man like me to be buried in America.
Never fear, Barley Salad, but I'll give you good brains the day you'll die.
Maybe it's you who'll be buried in the graveyard of Queen Margaret for me, Mary Fallon. And I myself will probably be dying under some night with no one near me. And the cat itself might be gone straight through the country, and the mice squealing into the kill.
Leave off talking of dying, would you? It might be 20 years before you'll be living yet.
If I'll ever be living at the end of 20 years, it's a very old man I'll be then.
Oh, good morning, Barty Fallon. Good morning, Mrs. Fallon. Well, Barty, you find no cause for complaint today. They're all saying it was a good fair.
Yeah.
Good fair? You call this a good fair? No, Mrs. Tarpey. It's more of a scattered sort of affair. If we didn't expect more, we get less. That's the way it would be always. Whatever I have to sell goes down, and whatever I have to buy goes up. Well, if there's ever any more misfortunes coming to this world, it's on myself if it's just like a flock of crows or sea potato.
Leave on talking of misfortunes, would you? And listen to Jack Smith. He's coming this way, and he's singing.
I thought much was love. There'd be not one house between you and me. I thought I would find yourself close to where I worry.
She's very worried of them for the things that caused mine in the fair. Oh, by the way, it isn't in the fair I came myself, but to the fine, yes, fine Avery Reynolds, where I got a contract for the hay. Look at the sheriff in the trance today.
You won't get into trance today. The rain will be down on it by evening, and on myself too. It's seldom I ever started on a journey, but the rain will be down on me before I find any place of shelter.
If it did itself, hardly. It's my belief you'd be wearing the leafy veil over your head in place of a hat. Where you'd be without a coat of prevailing. Or just bring an umbrella or something. By golly, look at that young mare of fat lions back to show us his clothes with the name of the cow. Don't get those fat and give me a hand. Bye everyone.
To be going home, Barley. I've got all this put in my basket. And look at there! Jack Smith paid for it, Barley. He'll be wanting it. Hurry! Jack Smith! Jack Smith! He's gone through the crowd, Barley. Hurry after him. He'll be wanting it.
Yeah,
hurry!
Oh, would you look at that? If there's never any basket this fair does upset, it is ours.
Get out of that! It's your own fault, it is. Of misfortunes and misfortunes. I mean, look at my new egg cup and my apple and my 2 pounds of sugar with the paper broke.
God help us! Mrs. Fallon, what happened to your basket?
Oh, it's himself that did it. Bad manners for him. He'll not have his tea without all the sugar on the ground. I have my best to go back to the shop and get some more.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Fallon. How are you? Where's Sparky Fallon?
Oh, hello, Kim. Why?
Actually, I wanted a word with her before you leave the fair. I was afraid you might have gone home by this, for he's a separate man.
Oh, I just wish that he'd go home. It'd be best for him to go back home straight from the fair green, or he'll just never come back at all. Where is he? Is it? He's gone up there, following Jack Smith with his hay fork. And me? I'll have my best to go back to the shop and get some more. Goodbye, Kim.
Oh, okay, following Jack Smith with a hay fork.
Following Jack Smith? With a hay fork? Did anyone hear the like of that? Mrs. Tarpey, did you hear the news?
News? What news?
I heard no news at all.
Tell me!
Some dispute, I suppose it was, that rose between Jack Smith and Barley Salad. And it keeps Jack made off and Barley throwing him with a hay fork!
Is he now? Well, that's what this is for. It's not that I mean it, since still they were here. Barney going home, and Jeff Smith going to five-acre meadows. And I had my apples to settle up the drama out of falling, was looking this way and that way. And when I looked around, so they were gone.
And Mrs. Fallon's basket.
And Mrs. Fallon's basket upset. Look at this. Tea there, sugar there, egg cups rolling everywhere.
Oh, no. Was it the rain heart? The deafness put upon me. They needed it here. The commencement of the fight.
But wait till I tell James Ryan that I stay below. He's a neighbor of Barley's. But it would be easy if he wouldn't hear all of you.
Look, it's like
telling me. I suppose that's what brought the photograph and magistrate up this way. I was wondering to see them and a while ago.
Then the police? After that? Point because it must have been injured so they would have been another 5 hours only for show.
Why would he injure him? There was many men killed with no more of a weapon than a hate for.
Yes, yes, with a hate for.
Okay, wait here. Wait till I know that's why I'm surely start spreading you.
I'll go to his first cousin that is standing there, south of the church, and for selling his land. Okay, I'll go tell him if he first. I think we are to the west.
Oh, wait, I'll go with you.
I'll get a word of it. At the east of the beach.
So we see this one, Orly. And tell me, do you see Kitty Carey, Amy, please?
Kitty Carey?
Yes, his wife.
Kitty Carey, let's see. Kitty Carey. Ah, I did. At her own house she was, right close to the hedge in her path.
Sorry, what did you say she was doing?
Sorry. Lay out the sheep on the hedge. That was his office.
Laying out the sheep for the dead? Laying out the sheep?
Get from any person in this parish.
How can he take charge of her? Sure he is
To America? Which pottery cask, Mrs. Kelly? Believe me. It is what America is making at this minute. I got a new magistrate, and no more than all the police going to the post office. They will turn in their face if I be sure he was to telegraph their wins.
What is it the whole town is talking about? And what is it yourselves are talking about? Is it about my man, Polly Fallon, you're saying? Is it lies that you went killing Jack Smith? Like me, that you never come into this place at all.
Be easy, Mr. Fallon. Just be easy. Sure, there's no one in this whole affair. But it's a story for you.
Yes, yes, sorry for you.
Sorry for me? Is it? Be sorry for me. Let you be sorry for yourself. And that there may be shame on you on the day of judgment. For the words you're saying are lies. And you're taking away the character of my poor man. And drive him into destruction. Is that what you're doing?
Take comfort now, Mrs. Fallon. The police are as much as they think. Sure, they might get him to say yes. As they must take it, John.
If they do get him, and if they do put a rope around his neck, there's no one can say they do not deserve it.
Yes, he does deserve it.
Is that what you're saying, Bridgetelli? And is that what you really think? I tell you, it is too much to talk about making yourself such great ones and to be ruining every respectable person. A rope. Oh, really? It wasn't much of a rope that was needed to tie up your own furniture the day you came into Martin Tully's house, and you never bringing a blanket or a penny or even a suit of clothes. And me, myself, bringing 70 pounds and 2 feather blankets. And now, look at you. You are stiffer than a woman that will have 100 pounds. This whole town is full of liars and schemers that would hang you up for a glass of whiskey. My poor man, Bartley Fallon, till I bring you out of this. Did anyone see Bartley Fallon? Bartley!
It is hard for her to believe such a thing. God help her.
God help her.
It's like what I often said to myself. There's ever any misfortune coming to this world, it is on myself to deserve to come. To be going about with this fork, to find no one to take it, no place to leave it down. I just want to be gone out of this. Is that you, Shunnerly? It's very well I met you. Well, would you take this and keep it?
I will not take it, Bartley Fallon. I will take one for you.
Would you take this? Well, Mrs. Tarpey, it was here I got it. Let me thrust it under your stall. It will remain there safe enough, and no one will take it with a bit of such time as Jack's. That was a neighborly thing for you to do, Mrs. Harvey. Hadn't I got carried with this fork, running up and down with it like a swing of a clock, for it to lay down in any place? I wish I never touched this thing, or even meddled with it.
It's a speaking that you ever did, Brother Fallon.
Would you yourself think such strange, Ryan? You're always a neighborly man.
Well, buddy, there are many things that I would like to do for you. I will do that.
Now, I tell you that there's no man that will give you any help or encouragement for this great work. It was something agrarian now.
Fine. If not, I'll take this. Maybe it's best to give it up to the police.
Yeah,
okay.
If you won't have heard of them, surely. And if
funeral of Jack Smith.
Why wouldn't he get a funeral as well as another? Would you be regretting that much?
Red Jack Smith, dead. Who was telling you this?
The whole town must have this by now.
Does this make the way to the guy?
Well, Barley, you don't know, I suppose. You don't know that he was followed, and he was laid dead with the staff of a hay fork.
The staff of a hay fork?
And you don't know, I suppose, that his body was found laid dead on the five acre meadow?
The five acre meadow?
It is likely you don't know that the police are after the man that did it.
The man that did it?
You don't know, maybe, that he was made aware for the sake of Kitty Carey, his wife?
Kitty Carey, his wife?
And what have you to say now for me, Felon?
I need to bring this forth here. Just find that news for me. It is much if I get Mr. away from this place, or even I reach as far as the road.
Look, boy, and then you magistrate, and you're walking along with him. It is my trust
to good. I believe so. I do not wish to be mixed in this business at all.
Then, as he is, I wouldn't want to be an informer of my own enemy.
Right, so.
But I did not expect to be confronted with a murder at the first fair I came to.
I'm sure you did not, indeed.
It was lucky I had not gone home. I got a few words here and there that rose my suspicions.
So they would too.
You heard from everyone you asked?
The same story, or if it was not altogether the same. Anyways, it was no less than the first story.
Look! What is that man doing? He is sitting alone with a hay fork. He has a guilty look. The murder was done with a hay fork!
That's the very man they saved it to act. But we found himself.
He must have found escape difficult. He is trying to brazen out of it. A convict in the Andaman Islands has tried the same game. But he could not escape my system. Stand aside. Don't go far. Have the handcuffs ready. Here, my man. Do you know anything of John Smith?
Eh? Of John Smith? Who is he now?
Jack Smith, sir. Red Jack Smith.
Oh, Jack Smith. Where is Jack Smith?
Well, where's he, indeed?
What have you to tell?
Well, it was here he was this morning, standing in that spot, singing his sheriff's songs, lighting his pipe, scraping a match on the sole of his shoe.
I ask you, for the third time, where is he?
I would have liked to say that. It's a great mystery, and it's hard to say of any man. Did he earn hatred or love?
Tell me all you know.
All that I know? Well, I know that there are three islands. There's Bali, there's Java.
Nonsense! This is Tripoli. Get to the point.
Maybe you don't hold with the clergy, so. That's a teaching of the clergy. Or maybe you hold with the old people. They do be saying that the shadow goes wandering, and the body's tired, and the soul's taking rest. The shadow? The shadow. I was sure I saw Jack Smith not 10 minutes ago near the forge, and I lost him again. Was it his ghost that I saw, do you think?
Conscience struck. He will confess all now.
Oh. It's likely it was on account of the fork he's looking for me. I do have the fork, and he do have no way to defend himself the time he met with his death.
I must note down his words. I warn you that your words are being noted.
If I just run faster in the beginning, the stir will not be on me on the latter end. Maybe he will cast it up against me on the day of judgment. I wouldn't want her at all, Ted.
At the day of judgment.
Does it always come after me by day, will be? And then stripping the clothes off in the nighttime? I wouldn't want her at all, Ted. Being as I am, an unfortunate man.
Tell me this truly. What was the motive of this crime?
The motive, is it?
Yes, the motive. The cause.
I'd sooner not say that.
You had better tell me truly. Was it money?
Money? No, not at all. He was... What did poor Jack Smith ever had in his pockets? Unless it might be his hands that would be them.
Any dispute about land?
Land? No, not at all. He was never was a grabber who grabbed from anyone.
You will find it better if you will tell me at once.
I tell you, I wouldn't for the whole world wish what it was. It is a thing I would not like to be talking about.
There is no use in hiding it. It will all be discovered at the end.
Well, I suppose it will. Seeing that most everybody here knows about it before. Okay, whisper here now. I will tell no lie. Where would be the use?
Don't be putting the blame on the parish, for such a thing was never done in the parish. It was done for the sake of Kitsikaru, Jackson's wife.
Aha! Put on the handcuffs! We have been saved some trouble. I knew he would confess if we'd taken it the right way.
Handcuffs now? Glory be! It's like what I've said to myself. If there's ever any misfortunes coming to this world, it is on myself that is sure to come. Look, I to be on handcuffs. There's no wonder at all that.
This whole town is full of liars, speaking against my poor respectable man, saying he has been an end of Jack Smith. There is no nicer man and no better man in this whole five parishes. It was just a little annoyance he ever gave to anyone. What is it in the earthly world do I see before me? Barley Fallon, in charge of a police? Handcuffs on him? Oh, Barley, what did you do at all?
Oh, Mary, there has been a great misfortune.
What did he do at all, or is it bewitched I am? This man has been arrested due to a charge of murder.
Whose charge is that? I don't believe in them. They're all liars in this place. Give me back my man.
It is natural you should take his part, but you have no cause of complaints against your neighbors. This man has been arrested due to a charge of murder of John Smith at his own confessions.
Jack Smith, sir.
Yes, John Smith.
John Smith.
Saints of heaven, protect us.
What did he want killing Jack Smith?
It is best you should know all. He did it on account of a love affair with the murdered man's wife.
With Jack Smith's wife? With Kitty Carey? Oh, come! You traitor!
Indeed!
To America, he was bringing her.
Wait, what are you saying, Mary?
Don't say a word! I won't listen to anything you say! Oh, isn't he a treacherous villain?
Let you be quiet till I speak. Listen to what I have to say.
Sitting beside me on the car.
Your wits that you have lost, or is it mine?
And it's hard that I've earned you, slaving and slaving, and you grumbling and sighing and
just. Would you just shut your mouth and hear me speak?
And if it was for any sort of fine, handsome woman, but for a little fistful woman like Kitty Carey, not even 4 feet high, and not even 3 teeth in her head. Well, unless she got new ones. May God reward you, Barley Fallon, for the black treachery like this in your heart and the wickedness in your mind, and the red blood of Jack Smith is wet upon your hands.
The sea shall be dry, and the earth mourning in man, that loud shall he cry for the wife of the red-haired man.
It's Jack Smith's voice. I never knew ghosts to sing before. Let one of you give him the fork, and I'll be done with him for eternity.
Jack Smith, the man that was going to be buried!
Isn't
blind you are? Or is it it you are?
Is it yourself and all that's in it?
Is it letting her to be dead?
Dead or alive? Let you stop hitting Carrie, your wife, from bringing my man with her to America.
Is it what I think? So what's it gonna share in all of you? What my wife want bringing a man like Bartley Fallon to America?
To leave yourself and to get quit of what she wants of you and take away my man with her. That's what the two of them have settled together.
I'll break the head of any man that says that. Who is it says it? Is it you who says it?
I who said I? Who said I?
Or you?
Who's me?
How about you?
It wasn't me. It wasn't me.
Tell me the name of any man that said that.
Bartley Fallon.
Any woman to be crossing the ocean with. It's back from the docks of New York, he'd be turned with a lie in his mouth and a treacher in his heart and another man's wife by his side, passing her off as his own. Let me at him, can't you?
Policeman, arrest him!
What?
I see it all now. False impersonation of Jack Smith to defeat the ends of justice. This too was a case in the Andaman Islands. A murder of the leader of the Mosca tribe. A religious enthusiast.
So it might be too.
We must take both these men to the scene of murder to investigate the body of the real Jack Smith.
I'll break that of any man that'll find my dead body.
I'll go find some more help from the barracks.
It's what I'm thinking. If I and Jack Smith are put into one cell together, the handcuffs will be taken off him, and his hands will be free, and murder will be done that time surely.
Come on!
GMIS chose to stage an Irish play, spreading the news. The simple menfolk of a village were taken in by a rumor, which led to a series of funny situations, making the ribs of the audience tickle. But at the same time, through this light comedy, the gravity of situation cannot be ignored, that an information mishandled and spread around callously may bring forth awkwardness for all those who are involved. We all know acting is about action and reaction. Daniel, as Mr. Bartley Fallon, reacted appropriately and accurately to the actions of other actors, be that Shivani as Mrs. Fallon, a firm but affectionate lady. Lisa as Mrs. Tarpey, a lady hard of hearing, speaks little, but with her artics wins us over. Ritisha as Mrs. Kim Array, who spreads the news. Adrian as Jack Smith. Caesar as Sean Arun, Tristan as Charlie, Matthew as the peculiar magistrate, Yaya and Mahesa as his assistants, Jason, Milo, Rona, and not to miss Leonie, the narrator. An effort made by all the actors brings forth a beautiful play. Well done, boys and girls. Why, tonight I felt I was in the Abbey Theatre. Till last evening, parents, guardians, I was afraid. I was kind of cursing why we don't own an Abbey Theatre, why GMIS Bali is not having an auditorium. Tonight I feel I have IB students who will create their own theatre, their own stage, their own sets, action and direction. Very well done, boys and girls. Behind stage. I would not have done my job fully if I don't thank the teachers. May I request them to come here, please, as I call out their names. Mr. Ravi and his team of teachers, art directors and stage managers, Mr. Ketu, Vidhi and Paras. Come here. Mr. Emil. Come here, Mr. Emil. Music director, Mr. Peter. Music and sound. Probably sit down so that they can be seen. Spotlights, Mr. Vivek and Mr. Vijay. Mr. Devender. Cast coordinator, Mr. Ahmed. Costume designer and makeup, Ms. Nilima as costume designer, also makeup. Other people for makeup, Ms. Adi, Ms. Yuni, Ms. Ekaneg. Photography, Pakoma. Come here, Pakoma. Video, Mr. Samuel and Park Moses. Logistics, Mr. Michael Clark, and of course the directors, Ms. Neha and Mr. Arun. The middle school play is also supporting and sponsoring residents for the year 2015-16. They are Ni Kate Sortini and Ni Putu Emma Andreni. The funds collected through this play will go for their education. On behalf of GMIS Bali, I wish to thank our sponsors, Restaurant Renon, Massimo, Gacha Biru Bungalows, Salon Rudy, Press Readers, and all those anonymous donors who have helped us. In pursuing this noble cause. Thank you very much. Good night. Good night and enjoy the evening.